What's up, guys? There are many debates whether a mini PC is good for gaming, but there's no doubt that it is perfect for business because it is compact, energy efficient, and its performance is enough for all office tasks. The Minis Forum UM1250 is one of the latest and most interesting business mini computers because it is powered by Intel Core i5-1250P processor with Intel vPro support. According to Intel's website, Intel vPro is a business computing foundation that makes PCs professional-grade with the latest AI technology. Help protect your business with the best security and remote management capabilities. There is a lot of information here about the features and benefits of Intel vPro, but I don't want to dwell on that now. If you are interested, I will leave a link in the description under the video. In addition to the Intel i5-1250P processor, this mini PC has Intel Iris Xe graphics, 16GB of RAM and 1TB of SSD. We will definitely check out the performance of the Minis Forum UM1250 mini computer, but first, let's unbox it and see what comes in the package. You know, the mini PC comes in a simple cardboard box, and it only has Minis Forum logos on all sides. By the way, this computer belongs to the Venus series, which has not only business PCs, but even gaming ones. The sticker on the back says the model, processor, GPU, memory and storage. Opening the box, first we see various documentation, such as user manual in different languages. A warning not to remove the CPU cooler themselves, and a possible reason for the slow boot time. Then there's the mini PC itself. We will look at it a little later. At the very bottom of the box are the power adapter, power cable, HDMI cable, and a visa bracket with mounting screws. You can use it to install the mini PC on the back of your monitor. As you understand, this mini PC is already assembled and ready to use. All you need to do is to plug it in and connect your monitor, mouse, and keyboard. Later we will try to open the computer and see what's inside. But for now, let's look outside. The Minis Forum UM1250 comes in only silver color. I think its design says it is an office computer, not a gaming, right? But I still like its minimalistic look. There is only the company logo at the top. The front panel has the most used connectors, such as two USB-A 3.2 Gen 2 ports, 3.5mm audio jack, power button, and clear CMOS. The rear panel has more interfaces, such as two USB 2.0 ports, DisplayPort, RJ45, 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, HDMI, USB 3.2 Type-C, and a 19V DC input. There are ventilation windows on the back, sides, and even the bottom. The bottom grille is so big that we can see what's inside. But let's try removing the bottom cover and take a closer look at the insides. First, we need to remove the four rubber feet. And then unscrew the four bolts. I'm most interested in RAM and SSD here. The Minis Forum UM1250 mini PC has two 8GB DDR4 memory modules pre-installed. However, you can install up to 64GB of RAM. As for storage, there is a 1TB M.2 2280 SSD, but if that's not enough for you, you can install 2TB drive here. I see that there is a Kingston SSD pre-installed here. We will check its read and write speeds a bit later. The CPU cooler is actually located under the motherboard, and the manufacturer does not recommend removing it yourself to avoid damaging the motherboard and the CPU. Let's put the computer back together. Okay, enough about design. Let's turn it on already. First, I want to check the boot speed. However, I have already installed games and programs. So the mini PC is not exactly out of the box. However, it started up in just 16 seconds. I think that's really fast. So now I'm interested in the thermal design power, or TDP for short. This is very important for mini PCs, because it shows the power consumption. As you know, this is one of the main features of any mini PC. It also determines the performance. First, we can go to the CPU benchmark website and read about the Intel Core i5-1250P processor that is installed in the Minis Forum UN1250 mini PC. We will come back to this site a little later, but right now we are interested in the TDP. It is claimed to be 28 watts. Now we can run the CPU-Z and Core Temp programs on the computer. As you can see, the TDP of this mini PC is 28 watts. When the computer is in standby mode, its TDP is under 10 watts. If we run the stress test and the processor is loaded at 100%, the TDP is 45 watts. This is the maximum power this mini PC is designed for. By the way, you can plug this computer with a monitor into a power station. And it will run up to 12 hours. Mini PCs are also much quieter than full tower computers. For example, the noise level of the Minis Forum UN1250 is only 40 decibels in standby mode, and up to 50 decibels at full performance. Before we talk about hardware and performance, I should say that the mini PC runs on the Windows 11 Pro. It is official and activated. Okay, let's go back to the hardware. On the CPU benchmark website, we can see that Intel Core i5-1250P is a laptop-class processor. Its multi-thread rating is 19,948 and single-thread rating is 3514. In this chart, we can see that this is above the average CPU mark of February 2025. As for the memory and storage, my mini PC has two 8GB DDR4 3200 RAM sticks. You know, two 8GB memories are better than one 16GB memory because they work in dual-channel mode and provide better performance. However, you can also install two 16GB RAM sticks and even two 32GB modules. So the mini PC supports up to 64GB of RAM. When it comes to storage, the computer is equipped with a 1TB M.2-2280 PCIe 4.0 SSD. If necessary, it can be replaced with a 2TB drive. By the way, the SSD is from Kingston, so the read and write speeds should be good. Let's check it out. Yes, indeed, the read speed is 4520 megabits per second, and the write speed is 4040 megabits per second. That's very good for a budget mini PC. As for the other benchmarks, there are 2133 points in a single core test and 8189 points in a multi-core test of Geekbench 6. The OpenGL score is 12,225. The Cinebench R23 benchmark also tests single core and multi-core performance. Here we can see 1419 PTS and 8541 PTS respectively. Passmark benchmark allows you to see not only CPU performance, but also 2D, 3D, memory, and disk performance. All results are about below average. We should also run PC Mark and 3D Mark benchmarks. At the Minis Forum, UN1250 Mini PC has 57, 30 overall score in PC Mark, and it is a little lower than the office laptops. As for 3D Mark, I ran 3 tests here, such as Steel Nomad Lite, which was recommended for this computer, TimeSpy and FireStrike. The first test says the performance is excellent. We can see estimated FPS in some games. The TimeSpy score is 1535, and it is also great. That's above average and some of the best results. As for the third test, FireStrike, the score has not been validated online, but I think it is also a good result. Overall, the benchmark results are quite good for a business mini PC. But who are we not to try and play a few games? I have installed Dota 2, Counter-Strike 2, PUBG Battleground, Asphalt Legends, Marvel Snap, Once Human, and Destiny 2. Let's play these games, and then I will tell you what I think about gaming performance.
Meet the team. Spider-Man, you're in.
Take a look on the way over here. This place
in a constant state of flux, you see. If what we need to do is speed up that process.
Found us. I'll get us more light.
Stay focused. If you're trying to help.
You know, it is quite comfortable to play light games like Dota 2, Asphalt Legends, Marvel Snap on this mini PC, even in 1080p resolution. As for heavier games, such as Counter-Strike 2, PUBG Battleground, or Destiny 2, it is better to choose 720p resolution. Yes, the graphics are not the best, but I don't think you expect them from a budget office mini PC, right? But still, this mini PC is positioned as an ideal business partner for remote work, digital signage, video editing, and surveillance cameras. Let's try it for office and home tasks. First, I want to play a video on YouTube in 4K resolution. No problem with that. I can even rewind a video without lags, but it rather even depends on my internet speed. You know, I have a 100 megabits connection. Download and upload speeds are around 100 megabits both via Wi-Fi and Ethernet cable. When I downloaded games on Steam, the speed was 100 megabits as well. However, the RJ45 port in this mini PC supports up to 2.5 gigabits per second. Now I want to open 10 tabs with our videos in Google Chrome browser. You know, I don't see any delays at all. I can switch tabs and play all the videos with no problem. Okay, it's time to check out this mini PC for video editing. I created a project in Adobe Premiere Pro and added the 4K video here. The video rewinds with no problem and I can edit it. Exporting also doesn't take much time, only 34 seconds for 1 minute of 4K video. Since the Minis Forum UN1250 mini PC is designed for office tasks, you can run any office programs such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint. 2025 is a year of AI, so we cannot do without ChatGPT and DeepSeek. You can use them on this computer with no problem. By the way, I saw the picture that the mini PC supports triple monitor output via HDMI, DP, and USB-C. But I will not be able to test this, because my monitors are connected via HDMI. I think it would be better if the computer had a second HDMI port instead of DisplayPort. Do you agree with me? So Minis Forum UN1250 is a really good mini PC for office or home, because it has good performance thanks to Intel Core i5-1250P processor and high-speed SSD. You can make it even faster by installing up to 64 gigs of RAM instead of 16 gigs pre-installed. I cannot say it is a gaming mini PC, but you can play some popular games on it, like Dota 2 and PUBG Battleground. You know, I started this video talking about the Intel vPro feature, but I don't really know how to test it. Please write in the comments below if you know more about it. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon!